Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So from this particular video, we'll be starting to the most famous concept, that is object-oriented programming. So where we'll be dealing with the classes, we'll deal with the objects, inheritance, constructor, polymorphism, inheritance, and the abstractions. We'll be seeing what is encapsulation and what all the class method, what all the methods, what are the function overriding, function overloading, all those things. So I'll be saying you one particular suggestion. So object oriented programming is a very most useful particular concept in any particular programming language. So even if you are attending any of the interviews in your future, so the main thing they will be asking only about the object oriented programming. Okay, so it is not any like rocket science. It is very easy to understand. So very easy we can create the classes, very easy to create objects. So completely we will be dealing with the coding part. So we'll be starting from the particular each and every concept, like we'll be starting from the class, we'll see what is objects, and we'll be moving step by step in the coming videos. So now let's move on to the coding part. Okay guys, I have opened the particular notes over here. So here we'll be seeing object oriented programming. So we'll see what is object oriented programming. So it is nothing but a dry concept. As I said, do not repeat yourself. That means some part of the codes are there, like if I want to create some particular employee where I need to create 100 employees. So rather than creating 100 function to take the particular details, we'll create one particular class and we'll create 100 objects. So each object will be dealing as like a particular one employee. So with that particular object, we can extract everything of the particular employee, like the name, date of birth, what is the salary, and gender, and number of things. Okay. So where the object oriented programming is used here is in the OOPS, we deal with the classes as well as the object. So in the object oriented programming, as the sentence is an object, it returns, that means it is a collection of classes as well as the objects. Okay, what is class? A class is a collection of the objects. A particular class is a collection of the objects, and object is defined as an instance of the particular class, which is the passing attribute. So we'll see with the example, so where you will be understanding better. So understand, a class is a collection of objects, and what is object? Object is an instance of the class. If anyone asks you, you need to give this particular definition. Okay, so then we'll be seeing on to the instance, constructor, method, abstractions, as well as the inheritance with the depth. Okay, so now coming back to the how to define a particular class with a Python program. So the particular keyword we are using here is a class. So class is a keyword to declare a particular class, and class and the class name. So always use the class name as a capital letter of the starting class name. So anything, it can be anything rather than the keyword or a function names, the class names. Okay, here classes are not the function, so we do not have the used to keyword define. Create a class, instead we are using a keyword. Class along with the name, and also we do not have a class or hold, instead we use object as well to define a different attribute. So basically, so how to create a particular class? We'll create a class. Suppose if I want to create an object for this particular class, I need to just call the particular class, the particular class name with the attributes, and I can just easily create the particular obj one as like this. Okay, so now let's come back to the coding part over here. So I'll just open my Visual Studio Code. So we will be creating one particular folder, so we'll see how the particular things works. So here what I'll do, I'll just close everything. Now what I'll do here is I'll just create one more folder. So I'll just create one more folder, I'll just make it as a OPPS oops. So inside the oops, I'll just create one particular oops 1.py file. So object oriented programming, first program as we are dealing with right now. So here first we'll see, we'll create one particular class. So what is the class name I'll give? I'll just give the class name is equal to friends. So I'm giving the particular class name is equal to friends. This is my class name. In my class friend, we have some value. Think it is a variable of the class. I'm giving a value is equal to temp. Then I'll just create nothing. I'll just create this much. Okay. So now I need to create a object for the class. So this is how we have created the particular class, class and the class name. Now I need to create a particular object to the particular class. Suppose now I want to give one particular object. So I'll just tell obj1 is equal to, so I'll just call this particular class as a friends. So I'm just calling this particular friend. That means my object is been created, done. So now if I just tell, so I want to just tell print what is the particular type of the obj one, that is a obj1. Now if I run the particular program, so if I just run the program, you'll be seeing here what you'll be seeing here, it is a class, that is a main friend. That means it is a class, that means it is an object. Okay, it is just a particular object of the particular class, that is a friend. The class name is friends and obj is a one object. I can create a number of objects. I can create a object 2, I can just create a object 3, and number of things. Okay, so now if I just tell, so I will just tell a particular thing. So now what I'll do here is, so now I can just particular add the particular n number of names. Suppose I want to create object, so I want to pass one object. I'll just tell obj1 dot name. I want to just set the particular for this particular object, so I'll just slide it down. So here what I'm doing for this particular class friend, I am declaring one particular attribute that is a name. So when I am declaring a name, I am just passing the particular name. Suppose now I want to give the particular name as Sakina over here. So I'm just passing the name over here. So then after passing the particular name, I want to pass the gender. I'll just tell obj dot gender is equal to, I'll just tell female. Okay, I'm just passing the name as well as the gender. So then I can pass a number of attributes. You can pass the name, gender, and a number of things you can pass. Okay, it's completely your choice. So after passing it, if I just tell print, I want to just tell print obj.1. So when I tell obj.1, if I run the particular program, so what I'll be getting? So here I'll be getting what is the position. That means I'm just getting the object particular, what you call the particular address. So suppose now I want to call obj1 dot. So now I want to print what is the value of a. So I can just, I have created objects of the class friend. So I'll just remove these two objects. I'll just tell you about one. So I have declared a obj1, that is a class. Then for this object, I can call any variable. Even I can assign any values to a particular attribute. We can create an attribute and we can just store it over there. If I just tell obj.1.a, so I want to just tell print what is my object a value. So what it does means it will just print 10, because in my class a is equal to 10, that is the value it is going to print. Same way, if I want to print one more thing, that is a obj, I'll just tell obj.name. I want to just print what is the name of the object one. So if I run the program, you can see I'm getting as a Sakina. That means because I have set the particular value to a attribute, it is a new attribute which I have declared, name obj1.name Sakina. So if I want to print the gender also, I can just print the particular gender obj1.gender. If I just save the program and run, you can see I'm getting output as Sakina as well as a 10. First I'm getting as a value is 10, name is Sakina, and gender is female. So like this, easily I can just print the particular things. So next, suppose I want to create one more object. This is just a one complete object. This is my complete one object. So now I want to create one more object. I'll just tell this is my object 2, obj2. So I'm just creating second object. So for, I'm just calling the class then, that is friends. So now object 2 is created. So for the object 2, I can just set the particular name. I'll just set the particular name here. I'll just tell as a Adi. I'll just tell as Aditya as object 2 name. So same as well as I'll just give it as age. So I'm just setting the particular age is equal to 22. So two things I have set. So after setting, I can just print a particular object 2 dot a. Even I can call object 2 dot a. So here object 2 is an object instance of the class, that is a friends. So as it is an instance of the class, it can access anything from the particular class. So in the class, we have a is equal to 10. I can access the particular value here. I can just tell obj2 dot a, as well as I can just tell obj2 dot, I can just set whatever the name I have set, I can access it, and even I can access what is the age of the particular friend. If I run the program, you can see first the object one is getting printed, Sakina female 10, then second object is getting printed. So where I am getting obj2 dot a, 10 has been getting printed, then for the name, the Aditya has been getting printed, as well as for the age, 22 has been getting printed, because I have set the particular values to it. For the particular object, so for the particular class objects, I have set the particular values. So this is how we can create a particular class, and we can create an instance variable over there. So for the local variables, and we can access it in my terminal. Even I can set the particular value for the particular attributes, that is name, gender. We can add a number of attributes to the particular class. So it is, we are adding it explicitly over here. Okay, so where we are creating an object. So this is how to create a class, so, and the objects. I hope you have understood how to create a particular class as well as a particular object. Okay, so now next I'll just create one more. Now next we'll be seeing next coming next other concept. So now I'll just create in my exercise, sorry, in my oops, I'll create second program. So here I'll just make it as oops2.py file. So in my oops2.py file, we'll see what all the things we can do. Now what I'll do here is I'll just tell class is equal to friends. I'm just making class is equal to friends over here, where I'm creating a class. So for the friends, I'm giving one stars. So I'll just tell set the particular stars is equal to 5. Okay, so I'm giving 5 stars to my friends. So now I want to see for whom I'm giving the particular 5 stars. So now what I'll do here is I'll just create two particular objects. So I'll just create two objects. So first I'll just create Harshit. He's my one object. So he is the object of the class friends. I've created one object. Now I'll just create one more object. It is Aditya. So for the Aditya, I'm just creating one more class. That is a friends. I'm just creating a second object. That is a Harshit as well as Aditya. So now these are my friends name. So these friends are nothing or the objects. And this is the class of the friend whichever I have declared. So now I have created the two particular objects. So I'll just tell here. So I'll just tell two object for the particular class is created. So what is the class name? Friends. So for the two object for the class friends has been created. Done. So now I'll just set the particular names here. So what I'll set? I'll just set the particular names over here. So I'll just tell for the Harshit. For I'll just tell Harshit dot for this particular name. I am just setting the particular name. So his name is Harshit. So let's tell Harshit Bhaskar. Okay. So I'll just make it. I'm just setting the particular name of it. Again, I'll just tell Harshit dot particular age. I'm setting the particular age for him. So age I'll just give it as a 22. So it can be any number also. It can be just a number. So then I'll just tell Harshit dot the particular age. So I'll just sorry. Now after the age, I can just tell salary over here. So what is his salary? I'll just make it as 1,50,000. Something like this. So same as it is, I'll just set it for one more person. So for what is the person? For this time, I'm setting for the Aditya. So I'll just tell Aditya over here. Sorry, I need to just copy. I'll just tell Aditya, Aditya, Aditya. So for him, I'll just change the particular name over here. Aditya Rajat. So his age is around, I'll just make it as a 23. So his total salary is 2,50,000. Okay, something I'm just saying like this. So I have created a class, I have created a two objects, I have set the attributes, name, age, as well as the salary for the particular two persons. Now what I'll do, I'll give the particular stars to them. So I'll just give the particular stars. So here for him, I'll just give Harshit dot stars. So I want to give the stars is equal to, I want to give him 4 stars. I'm giving his stars is equal to 4. For particular Aditya dot stars, I'm just giving as a 3 stars. I'm giving him 3 stars. Okay. So now what I'll do, I'll just print the particular thing. So here I'll just use the F string. So I'll just tell this is the class stars. I want to print the what is the class stars. So if I want to print what is how the class stars are, directly I can tell. So I can just call the particular class name here. I can just tell friends dot stars. Directly I can call. So friends dot stars is nothing but for the friends, what is the value of the stars is there, it will get accessed and it will get printed. Okay, so this is all about one thing. So next I want to say this is the particular Aditya stars. So before Aditya, I'll just print the Harshit stars. Okay, so this is the Harshit stars. So what I'll just tell here is whatever the Harshit stars are there, I want to print it. So same way I want to print the Aditya stars, A-A-D-H-Y-A, Aditya. I need to make it as a S-T-E-R-S. So here also S-T-E-R-S. So even here also S-T-E-R-S. Okay, stars. So here this time I want to print what is the Aditya stars. So what is this Harshit as well as Aditya? These are the objects. So one object I have created. This is the second object I have created. For the particular objects, I am giving the attributes, name, age, salary, as well as the stars. So that I am accessing it here. If I run the program, you can see I'm getting, this is the class star. So what is, this is the class star, friends.stars. Friends is my class name. Whatever the attribute stars are there, it is printing 5. So now if I am setting the particular stars over here, so default is 5 have been provided. So now what I am saying, I am just setting one more star, that is Harshit dot stars I am printing. So here I am just changing the values of the stars. So whatever the values I have changed, that particular values will reflect over here. You can see it is 4. Here I have changed for 3, it has been reflecting over 3. Suppose if I have not changed the particular, if I have not declared for the stars, for Aditya I am not declaring the stars over here. So at that time what it will take? It will take the default value as 5. You can see this Aditya star is 5. So here I am just doing comment. I am not setting it. If I am not setting the values is going to take from the particular class name. So whatever the class values you have been specified, that particular value will going to take in the particular output. Okay. So this is all about the particular thing. So next we'll be seeing what is the, so I'll want to print what is, so I'll just tell you here. So here I'll just tell, so I'll just tell, I'll just say here, I'll just mention as Harshit. Hershey dot. So what is this particular things does? What is the dict? So we'll see what this particular dict will do. If I run the program, so dict will be doing what? So when I'm using a Hershey dot dict, so it is taking everything, whatever the thing is there, it is coming in the form of a dictionary. You can see name is Harshit Bhaskar, age is 22, salary is 51,50,000, stars are 4. When I am using it, iPhone, that is a dict, what it is giving me? It is giving me complete information of this particular object. So whatever the key, whatever the keys are there and whatever the values are there, it is just giving in the form of a dictionary when I am using a dot dictionary. So same as it is if I just use it for the friends dot dict. If I run the program, you can see at that time, whatever the things are there, everything I'll get. So modules are there, main is there, stars is there, dictionary, attributes of friends, objects one, and the friends, objects, document none. So whatever the things are there with the complete class, whatever the things we have and now we have objects, we have the inbuilt function stars, then we have the attributes, that is attributes are nothing but age, salary, as well as the stars. That complete things it will going to give me in my console, whatever the things is related with the class name, that is friends. So like this, we can print the particular class, so we can create a class, we can create an object, we can give the particular attributes for the class in this particular way, and even we can change the values of a variables in, within the class, and we can use the dict function. So these are all the things we can do it here. So next, we will be moving on to the next concept. So I'll just create the one more file, that is I'll just make it as OPPS oops3.py file. So in my oops3.py file, we'll see little bit about the init function. So if I just open you the notes, so here what I have said, what is an object, what I have said about the object, the state which is represented by the attributes of the object which reflects the properties of an object, the method of the object which represents the behavior of the object, and response of the object with the other objects. So you guys just see what are the things we have. So now we'll see what is the instance variable as well as the class variable. Instance variables are the variables for which the value of the variables is different for every instance. That means, so as we seen in the two, so this is a instance variable. So what this is an instance, this is also instance variable. That means I am just changing the particular values over here. So class variables all, this is the particular class variable. So we can change the particular class variable using the instance variable of the particular object. So like this, that is what I have said you over here. Okay. So now, so as well, I have just said you about this one. So now we'll be moving on to the concept of method, self, as well as the init and the constructor. So what is a method? So we have seen the functions, right? In the Python programming, we have seen the functions. So functions are nothing but a method. I can call functions also as a method, the same meaning. So method is just like a function, as I said. So the purpose of the method is used to show all the details related to the object. That means we are using a function so that we can display all the details of the particular object. Suppose I'm creating a class employee. So in the class employee, we are creating 100 employees. So if I want to print one employee details, so everything I need to print in a single thing. So at that time, I will create one function. So in that particular function, I'll pass all the attributes like name, salary, age, everything. So just I can call the particular function name, get details, employee details, like that. So when I call the particular employee details with the object, the function, that is object.employee details. When I'm calling this line of code, this piece of line, I need to print all the details of the employee at that time where the methods is used. Okay, so it is all about the self. So self, the self keyword is used in the method to refer the instance of the current class. So that means self, we are using it, whatever the instance, whatever the current class it has been used, it will refer to the particular current class or whatever the object is there. We are using the self keyword is to pass a parameter explicitly every time we are using in the method. So we are just, we can just pass the self method like this. So it can be anything, not only self, you can pass anything, self, self dot name, anything. What it is not like you need to use self only, you can use any other name also. We'll see what is init. So now init is a constructor. So what is init? Init is an initialization like that. So it is also called as a constructor in the object oriented programming. So init is also called as a constructor. The constructor in the Python is used to assign a values to a variable. So constructor, whenever you are calling a class, there is a default constructor will be running inside the program. So even you can create your own constructor. So that is nothing but init, you call it as a constructor. So where we have the values, data members, as well as a number of things, you can see def init, we can just call the self constructor, we can just pass any other body of the constructor. The def keyword is a function, you know, this is a function name, and init is a method. This is a, init is a method, or optional, we can define a pass the arguments object to bind instance to the particular class method. So coming back to the coding part, we'll understand with a coding related, we'll see how exactly the particular things works over here. So I'll just close everything. So here I'll just create one file. I'll just make it as oops4.py file. So I'm just making as a oops 4.particular Python file. So in my oops 4, so we'll see what are the things we can talk. So here I'll just create the particular class employee. So I'm just creating the particular class employee. So inside my class employee, so I'll create what is the employee of the class. So I'll just pass the particular company name here. So here company name, I'll just give it as AI Robotica. So let's say AI Robotica Services Private Limited. So this is a company name of the class. Okay, so now what I'll do here is I'll define one particular constructor here. So here I'll just create a constructor. I'll use a def keyword. So I'm just creating one constructor. I'll just tell in it. So I'm just calling one particular constructor. So it will take what? It will take the particular default as a self argument. Default it is taking as a self argument. Now I'll just put it as a pass over here. So I am just using a password so that I don't need to come back any error. Later I'll come and define what all the things is there. So now we created a company class of an employee. We created an employee company name. We have created one constructor. So inside the constructor, we'll see what is the constructor is there. Next, what I need to do here is, we'll see we have just created this much. So now I'll just create one particular object. So now I'll just pass the particular object one. So I'll just create a object one is equal to. So I'll just tell object one is equal to. I'm just creating one object employee. I'm creating the object that is a employee. So before we were doing obj.1.name, obj1.age, obj1.salary, all those things. So that is one thing of doing. So one more way, we can just pass the values here itself in the function. So here I'll just pass the particular employee name. Suppose think employee name is Harry. So employee name is Harry. I'm just passing Harry as employee name. And I'll just pass his salary. I'll just tell 90 lakh. So sorry, I don't know how many zeros are there. So I'm just passing some 90,000, I guess, his salary per month. Then I'll design his what is the role of the particular person. So the role of the person is software engineer. So the role of the person is software engineer. So I have created a Harry. I have created a 90,000. I'm passing. I'm just passing one more attribute is a software engineer. That means one particular employee have been created. So now what I need to do here means I want to print all the details of the employee. I want to print all the details of the employee. So what I'll do here is, so here I'll set the particular value inside the constructor. So here what I'll do, so employee is getting passed. So I need to pass 1, 2, 3 more attributes here. So for that one, I'll just call whenever I run the particular program, this init constructor will get called automatic. This is my constructor, which is going to run whenever I am creating an object. So here I'll just create, I'll make maintain as an emp. I'll just make it as an employee. Here I'm just passing the employee name, and here I'm just passing the employee salary, 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 and at the last I'm just think like I'm just passing the employee role. Okay, so I'm passing three arguments: employee name, employee salary, as well as the employee role. So this argument is going to pass over here as a self argument for the current instance object one. So now what I'll do here is, now I'll just set the particular value. Now I'll just set the particular value. So I'll just tell self.name. So for the name, I'm just going to set directly whatever the emb name is coming from the function call. So the particular, whenever the class is getting called, object is created. So the employee name will go here and it will be set it to as a self name. Same way, I'll just set it for the self dot. So self dot salary is equal to, for the self dot salary, I'll just maintain as emp salary. So again, for the self, I'll just maintain as I'll just make it as a self dot. So then what is the role, right? Self dot role. Here I'm just passing whatever the role of the employee is there. That value I'm going to pass as this one. So what it happens means, whenever I run this particular program, what it happens means object one will get created. Object one is getting created, and when it is created, it is going to call this particular constructor. So here if I just tell print, I just tell done the job. Okay, done the job. If I run the program again, you can see I'm getting done the particular job. That means whenever I created an object, it is going to call the default constructor. That is the init constructor it is going to call. So here I'll just mention it is my constructor. It is my constructor. This constructor is going to call whenever I run this, whenever I create the particular object. You can see done the job. That means it has been assigned as a self.name. That means it is assigned as a name. Self.name has been assigned for this particular object. It has been assigned this values. So now I say you to print object details. So here I'll just create one particular function now. So what is the function I'll just create? I'll just create the particular employee details. Employee details. So I want to call, so whenever I call object one dot employee details, I need to get all the things over here. So in my employee details, what it's going to take as a self argument. So whatever the self argument is there, it is going to take. That means whatever the self value is being set, this values is going to take. This values is going to the constructor, and my constructor is set all the values for this attribute as a self attribute values. Then that particular self I am going to pass to this particular function. So what this particular function does means it will just print all the details. So I'll just tell f strings. I'll just tell employee is working in the particular company name. I want to create, I know I want to pass the company name. So for this company, I'll call it as a self dot company. So I'm just calling the self dot company name. So then I want to go to the new line. So in the new line, I want to go to the new line. So then after creating the new line, I want to print. I want to just tell employee name is. So I'll just tell employee name is. Again, I'll just make it as a self dot employee. So I'll just tell self dot particular name. So whatever the name has been set, that is going to take. So then after this one, I'll just go to the again new line. So after new line, I'll just tell employee salary is. So I'll just maintain the employee salary is. So same, I'll just give it as a self dot salary. So this is one thing. So again, new line. So I'll just tell the employee role is. So here I need to pass the self dot role. Self dot role, right? Yeah. Self dot particular role. That means, see, I have just set the particular, I have created the particular function. Everything has been done. So now I want to call the particular object details. So I want to just print. I need to just tell print. I want to just tell object one, from the particular object one, I want to print what is the complete employee detail. So I'll just call this particular function. So I'll just tell obj one dot employee functions. I'm going to call like this. So now I'm going to call the particular employee function. When I run the program, you can see what is happening here. So you can see first the constructor has been getting called, all the values is been set after this line. Of course, if I just show you the flow of the diagram, I'll just tell after object is created. So after object is created, I need to go to the new line. If I run the program again, see what is in first, what happens means first object one is been getting created. When the object is getting created, this is going to call, this constructor is going to call defaulty. It has been set the value and I'm getting done the particular job. You can see done the particular job. So after this line of code, this particular line is getting printed. So what is this? After job is created, you can see it has been printed. Then next, I'm saying for my particular object one, I want to get all the employee details. So when I'm calling, you can see it is telling me employee is working in A Robotica Services Private Limited. Employee name is Harry. Employee salary is 90,000. Employee role is software engineer. I'm getting as a none at the last. If you don't want to get the particular none, just remove the print thing. So just tell obj.details. So when I just run this particular program, you can see obviously I'll be getting an output same. I'm not getting a none. So like this, we can create a particular object easily. You can say I created one particular thing. So now thing, imagine I want to print 100 employee details. What you need to do? Just one thing. Create one more object. Just create the particular one more object. So I'll just comment out this line. This is just I wanted to explain you. So I'll just comment this line. So just create the object too. So this time I'll just object is Anis. So this time Anis is a salary. My salary is 50,000. So I am a software. I'll just tell software tester. Okay, I'm just telling software tester. So again, what I'll call for the object two, I'm just calling the details of it. So here I'll just call the new line. I'll just print the particular new line over here. So now if I run the program, see, so easily I got the output. See, first for object one details has been getting printed. Employee is working is Air Robotica Services. Employee name is Harry. Employee salary is 90. and employee role is software engineer. The after this line is getting printed, object 2 is being created. Then I am just printing the object 2 details. So you can see employee is working in Aerobotica services. Employee name is Anis. Employee salary is 50k and the employee role is software tester. So easily I am able to print the particular thing. So here you can understand there is a no repeat concept is being used over here. Okay, so like this easily I can see. Even I can just tell directly if I want to get only what is the object 2 dot name, I want to just print what is the object 2 dot name here. I want to just see what is the object 2 dot name. Even I can do this one. If I run the program, you can see here object 2 dot name is Anis. You can see I'm getting Anis directly. Even you can directly see what is the object 2 dot role. So the object 2 role is software tester. So if I run the program, easily I can access the particular value. You can see I'm getting as a software tester. So easily I can access the particular functions from the objects of the particular class. All those things easily I can do it. Okay, so like this we can easily create the particular things. So next what I need to do here is so next we'll be seeing one more thing. So now I want to change the particular thing. I want to change the company name. So I want to change the particular company name over here. So what here is, suppose I want to change the company name. So how I can do that one? So what I'll do here is I'll create one function for it. I'll just create one particular function for it. So here something mentioned like change the company name. This function, this particular function, what does it will change the particular company name. It will just change the particular company name. So if it's what it changes the company name, it will take one two attribute. So it will take CLS. Okay, CLS it is going to take class, and it is going to take one more thing, that is one particular variable name, that is just as in this is my new company. I'm setting here, so I'm direct in explicitly I'm setting the values. So for this one, what I need to do when I'm just doing like this, what I need to do when I'm using a CLS, I need to declare it is as at the rate. I need to declare it as class method. I need to declare it as a particular class method. So after declaring the class method, now what I'll do here is now I can change. I'll just tell CLS dot company. So it does means it is just changing the company is equal to whatever the new value company I'm passing from here. That value is passing here, and that particular value is setting with this whatever the this class the company is there, which is I have defined over here. It is going to change with the new company name value. So now what I'll do here is for my I'll just tell obj2 for so let's tell for my obj2 for the obj2 dot I'm just setting I'll just tell whatever the change company, right? So I'll just tell obj2 dot change company. So here I'll just tell obj2 dot change change company. So with this particular object which I have created for the class employee, now I'm calling this particular change company. So I'm just telling change the particular company name to I'll just tell as Infosys. So I'll just tell I'm working in the Infosys. Now what it happens, now if I just try to print object 2 dot employee details, I'm calling the object 2 dot employee details. When I run the program, see here what is happening here. So the first it has been object 1, normally it is getting printed, it is going to the new line. So object 2 role is got printed, that is a software tester. So here I am just changing the particular company name. I'm just changing the particular company name to Infosys. After changing, I'm printing the object 2 details. When it is saying, see, employee is working in Infosys. Whatever the name I am passing it, it went to the particular constructor is called. Whatever the company is being, it is there, it is just changed. So how it is changed? I'm using at the rate class method as a decorator. This is a decorator I'm using. So this decorator what does means it will take the CLS as a first argument, and second the particular value which you are passing, which you want to change, that value are passing to the new company, that value is been I'm passing over here. So then I am just setting the CLS dot company, this class dot company, it is mean this particular class company variable you need to change the value to new company whenever this particular function is called. So this particular function is called for the object 2 where I am passing the argument, that is Infosys. This Infosys is going to pass to this new company value, then that particular new value is being set it over here, and it is being set it to cls.company. So then after changing the particular company, I am trying to print the employee details. It is just giving whatever the newly updated value is there, that is going to print it over here. So like this easily I am able to access the particular and particular details, and easily I can now change the particular values of the things over here. So this is all about the things. So we have seen about the class methods in the Python. So we have seen how the class method works, which takes CLS as the argument as well as the argument one. So that we call it as a class method decorator. So what it does means it takes in or in the short form as a CLS as an argument is must for the class. It is a must and should. With the help of the class method, we can change and alter the variable of the class. We can change and alter the particular variables of the class. So it is a variable of the class employee company. I am changing as well as I am doing an alteration. So then we can only use inside the class. That means this particular decorator we can use only inside the particular class. It is just telling us. And static is a no static regression. We will be seeing of the static also in the coming classes. So this is all about the particular things. I hope you have understood what is class, what is how to create an object, how to pass the attributes, again how to print the dictionaries and how to set the particular attributes, how to change the variable names of the class or values of the class. And we saw in my OOPS 3. So we saw in my OOPS 4 over here. So then we have seen all the things in the how to, what is a constructor. We have seen how the constructor works, how the particular things works over here. Okay, so actually I need to make it as OOPS 3 over here. We didn't have OOPS 4. I need to make it as OOPS 3. Okay, so we saw how the constructor is been getting called, how the particular employee details can be printed over here. We saw how the class method works. Okay, so in the coming classes, we'll be seeing about the like how to create a, how to call the particular self method and all those things. So now that's all for this particular video. I hope you have liked this particular video. You have understood what is class, objects, all those things. So I'll see you in my next video. Please access the notes in the description below. Share with your friends. Subscribe to my channel. Hit the like button in the below video. So I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Bye bye.